Good morning, everyone.
大家早上好。
It's a great pleasure for me to be able to have another chance to share from God's Word with you all today.
很高兴我再次有一次机会，再次有机会能够向大家来跟大家分享神的话。
So today we're going to be talking about sacrificial service.
那么今天我会跟大家分享牺牲性的侍奉是值得的吗？
With sacrifice in general, it requires for us to give up a lot of cost.
那这讲的侍奉呢，就是说我们会放下一些，会对我们会放下一些东西。
Sometimes we need to pay a big price in order to make that sacrifice.
我们会付出一些牺牲，然后才能有这些侍奉。
Now last month, there is an officer from Russia. His name is Officer Alexander, and he had to make a big sacrifice.
那大家看新闻可能知道，在上个月在俄国有个警察，他，我们看一下他所经历的。
He was in charge of escorting 9 buses full of 300 children back home after a whole summer from a camp.
那他就负责了将900个学生从他们的夏令营来返回到安全的返回到家里面。
And on one of the roads that they were traveling in.There was a car on the other side of the lane running really, really fast, and it was veering towards the other side of the lane.
那他们这些车在行走的时候呢，那从对面开过一辆车，向他们冲过来。
It was moving so fast that it was going to hit one of the first buses in the front.
因为这个车开错道了，所以他们就要眼看就要撞到他们的第一辆小车。
So Officer Alexander made the very quick decision, and without even thinking about his own life, he hit right head on into that car.
那个这个警察他叫亚历山大，那么他就为了保护这些校车不受撞，所以他就开他的警车就拦住这个向他们冲过来的这辆丰田车。
And as a result, he stopped that car from hitting any of the buses that were full of the children.
因为他所做的，所以这辆丰田车就没有撞到这些校车。
Thankfully, he was unharmed and he is now recovering.
那更感谢神，他并没有受太重的伤，现在他在恢复当中。
You see, we love to hear these types of stories where someone is willing to be able to sacrifice their life.
我们好像比较喜欢听看这些新闻，因为看到别人就是因为做出牺牲，让别人能够安全。
Especially in cases where lives are being saved.
特别是一些人生命能够被得到拯救。
But however, if we are ever in any similar situation, would we ourselves be willing to give up our life and make a big sacrifice like that?
那如果我们碰到类似的事情，我们是不会也愿意去做出这些牺牲呢？
Many times when we're serving God, you know, it requires some sort of sacrifice.
我们在侍奉神的时候，我们会做出一些牺牲。
We value our life.
我们会考虑到我们的生活。
We value our time.
我们会考虑到我们的时间。
Energy.
还有我们的能力。
And even money.
而且钱财。
And many times we find ourselves not willing to serve God because we do not want to risk losing what we value most in our life.
当我们在侍奉神的时候，我们有时候不愿意放下我们的生活，放下我们的钱财，放下我们的时间。
But yet, God still calls all of us as Christians to serve Him.
但是呢，上帝希望我们每个人都去来侍奉他。
So the question is sacrificial service for God worth the costs that are involved?
那现在想跟大家提的问题就是，这样牺牲性的侍奉是值得的吗？
Let us look in today's passage and we'll see why.
我们先看今天的经文，我们能够就看到为什么。
If you have your Bibles, I invite you to take them out and let's turn to Colossians chapter 1, verses 24 to 29.
如果大家有圣经的话，请翻到哥罗西书第一章24节到29节。
It is also displayed on the screen if you don't have your Bibles.
如果没有圣经的话，在前面会投影出来。
We'll read it together in English first, and then we'll read it in Chinese.
我们先用英文念一遍，然后再用中文念一遍。
This is Paul, the Apostle Paul, speaking to the Colossians.
这是使徒保罗给哥罗西教会所写的书信。
Verse 24. Now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I am filling up what is lacking in Christ's afflictions for the sake of his body, that is the church, of which I became a minister according to the stewardship from God that was given to me for you to make the word of God fully known. The mystery hidden for ages and generations now revealed to his saints. To them, God chose to make known how great among the Gentiles are the riches of the glory of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Him we proclaim, warning everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom that we may present everyone mature in Christ. For this I toil, struggling with all his energy that he powerfully works within me.
好，我们现在用中文念一遍。现在我为你们受苦，倒觉欢乐，并且为基督的身体，就是为教会，要在我肉身上补满基督患难的缺欠。我照神为你们所赐我的职分，做了教会的执事，要把神的道理传得全备。这道理就是历世历代所隐藏的奥秘，但如今向他的圣徒显明了。神愿意叫他们知道，这奥秘在外邦人中有何等丰盛的荣耀，就是基督在你们心里成了有荣耀的盼望。我们传扬他是用诸般的智慧劝诫个人，教导个人，要把个人在基督里完完全全地引到神面前。我也为此劳苦，照着他你运用的大能尽心竭力。
Let us pray together.
我们一起祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you.
亲爱的天父，我们来到你的面前。
We thank you for all the grace that you've shown in our life.
我们谢谢主，你对我们的爱。
And Lord, I pray that at this time as we look into your word, that you would teach us.
主啊，我们把我们的眼目定睛在你身上。
Please show us what it means to serve sacrificially for you.
让我们看到这个牺牲性的爱是如何。
May you open up our eyes and our hearts.
看我们的眼睛，看我们的心。
And Lord, please fill us up with your word.
愿你的荣耀，愿你的能力在我们心中来运行。
We trust in you no matter what.
我们信靠你。
And we lift up all these things in Jesus' name.
我们奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen. So the main question that we will be answering today is, why is sacrificial service worth the cost?
为什么牺牲性的侍奉是值得的呢？
And from the passage that we just read, we'll be able to figure out three reasons to answer that question.
我们今天的经文就给出我们有三点可以让我们知道牺牲性的侍奉是值得的。
Now let's start reading from verse 24 again.
我们再看一下24节。
Now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake and in my flesh.
现在
And I'm filling up what is lacking in Christ's afflictions for the sake of his body, that is the church.Of which I became a minister according to the stewardship from God that was given to me for you to make the word of God fully known.
使徒保罗说，现在我为你们受苦，倒觉欢乐，并且为基督的身体，就是为教会，要在我肉身上补满基督患难的缺欠。我照神为你们所赐我的职分，做了教会的执事，要把神的道理传得全备。
See, the Apostle Paul first tells the Colossians that God has given him a specific role.
那使徒保罗这么说到，上帝首先给你们一个角色，一个职分。
And that role is to be a minister.
那这个职分就是，做教会的执事。
In this passage, the word stewardship actually means a specific role in the household of God.
那这边中文是职分，那本来的意思是管家的意思。
And this role requires a lot of suffering and sacrifice.
那做管家是需要做出很多的牺牲的。
See, the Apostle Paul also says, I am filling up what is lacking in Christ's affliction for the sake of his body, that is, the church.
那保罗也说到，并且我为基督的身体，就是为教会，要在我肉身上补满基督患难的缺欠。
This verse doesn't mean that Christ's suffering was not enough on the cross.
这边讲的并不说基督在十字架上所受的苦不完全，并不是这样的。
Rather, it is saying that Jesus' suffering is not complete in the sense that Jesus still suffers as he ministers through the Apostle Paul and all of us as we serve.
这就是讲在基督，这边讲的确信就是说，他实际上是，基督透过保罗做这些事工的时候，还是接着有这些受苦，是透过保罗。
Being a minister for God involves much suffering and sacrifice.
做教会的执事，做基督的执事，做教会的执事会要一些牺牲。
You see, the Apostle Paul experienced a lot of persecution and beatings just for preaching Jesus Christ to the Jews.
我们在圣经可以看到，保罗其实为了主的缘故，受了很多的逼迫，很多的患难。
He risked dangers in his life as he traveled from place to place, overseas and across lands.
他在陆地上，在海路上，他到处传讲神的福音，一路都受很多的逼迫和患难。
Even right now, as he was writing this letter to the Colossians, he was sitting in prison.
那他在写这本哥罗西书的时候，他正在罗马的监狱。
You see, the Apostle Paul was willing to go through all this suffering.Just because God had called him to a specific role to be a minister.
保罗甘心乐意受这些苦，是因为主的缘故。
Now think about it. If someone is willing to go through all that suffering and making sacrifices for someone, it must be someone that he loves and respects.
那就想想，如果我们愿意去受这些苦的话，为某个人的话，这个人一定是我们所爱的、所尊敬的。
So why is sacrificial service worth the cost?
所以为什么牺牲性的侍奉是值得的呢？
This is the first point. God, the one whom we love and respect, is worth serving.
那第一点我想谈的就是说，上帝是我们所爱的，我们所敬养的，是值得侍奉的。
See, because of our love and respect for other people, our actions to them, no matter whatever the cost may be, is worth it.
当我们所爱，为我们所爱或者所敬仰的人来做事情的时候，我们愿意付出牺牲。
Let's start with the people that we love.
我们可以从我想想我们所爱的人。
For example, I love my brother.
那对我来说，我喜欢我的弟弟，他就在这。
Late last night, I went to the airport to pick him up.
那昨天晚上很晚半夜，我就把他从机场上带过去了，接他。
This past summer, he had an internship in California.
那这个夏天呢，他在加州有个实习生，做实习生。
Originally, I was supposed to pick him up at around 10:40 p.m.
然后本来我是在十点钟时候接，晚上十点钟接他的。
And then later I get a text from him saying that, oh, the plane is delayed for 2 hours.
然后我说他打了电话说，哦，我的飞机晚点2个小时。
So it wasn't until like about 1 a.m. I had to go to the airport to pick him up.
就直到凌晨一点钟我才接了他。
See, if I didn't love my brother, I wouldn't go pick him up.
如果我不爱我弟弟的话，我就不会去机场接他们。
He would probably still be at the airport even like right now.
他可能现在还待在机场呢。
And then last night I let him sleep in my bed.
那昨天晚上我也让他睡我的床。
If I didn't love my brother, I would make him sleep on the floor.
那我是睡在地上，如果我不爱他的话，我会让他睡在地上，我接着睡我的床。
And even this morning, I even gave him some of my food to eat.
我今天还给他早餐。
If I didn't love him, I wouldn't even feed him.
如果我不关心的话，我就让他随便。
You see, We can be initiative in making a sacrifice for someone that we love.
为我们所爱的人呢，我们会愿意付出牺牲的。
Now let's talk about people who we respect.
要想想我们所尊敬的一些人。
For example, let's say that one day your boss asks you to work overtime because there was a client and a deadline that need to be met.
那想想有一天你的老板让你加班，是因为有些事情需要你来做。
I mean, no one would willingly work overtime for no reason.
我想一般人是不愿意就是加班也不没有什么原因就愿意加班的。
I mean, we want to get home as soon as possible to be with our family and to rest.
我们都愿意回家，赶紧就回到家里面跟家人在一起。
But you agree to your boss's request to work overtime because of your respect for his authority.
那我们愿意这个加班，对老板那么说，是因为我们尊敬他们。
And also at the same time, you just don't want to get fired.
那不然的话，你肯定你工作也保不住嘛。
So this shows that we can be willing to make a sacrifice for someone who we respect.
所以我们想想我们自己，其实我们每次我们都会做的牺牲的，为我们所爱的人做的牺牲，为我们所尊敬的人做的牺牲。
This is the argument. If we can go out of our way to make sacrifices for people we love and people we respect, then how much more will we go out of the way to make sacrifices for God who gave each and every one of us a role?
那如果我们能够竭力去为我们所爱的人、所敬仰的人去牺牲的话，那么我们是否更应该为呼召我们、给我们一个角色的神做出更大的牺牲呢？
You see, our unwillingness to serve often comes down to the condition of our personal relationship with God.
那这么想想我们自己，我们不愿意为，如果我们不愿意为神做出牺牲的话，那可能就反映在我们跟神的关系并不是那么亲近。
That is why it is always important to go back to God and to spend time with Him in His Word and in prayer.
所以呢，跟神在一起，跟神祷告，有灵修的时间，这是很重要的。
And through spending time with Him, we can grow more in love and in respect for God.
当跟神在一起时间多的话，那么我们就会产生对神的爱，也会对产生对神的敬仰。
And as a result, it becomes more worth it to serve God sacrificially because of this.
那我们就会愿意为我们所爱的神，我们所敬仰的神去做的牺牲。
So the apostle, God called the Apostle Paul to the role of a minister.
那么上帝就呼召保罗这样一个职分。
We also need to think about what role has God called for you.
那想我们上帝呼召我们的职分是什么呀？我们给我们角色是怎么样的
？Yes, so the particular roles in church to be able to serve in.
特别是在教会，我们是做一位什么样的一个角色？
But do you know that there are actually other roles outside the church as well?
你想想，不只是在教会，上帝给我们每个人都有不同的角色。我们在社会上也是有上帝给我们每个人有不同的角色。
You see, very often we think that being a pastor or being a missionary, those are the spiritual roles.
我们常常想到我们要做牧师去做宣教士，好像这才是上帝所就是来呼召我们的一些角色。
But you see, whether you are an engineer, a business person, a restaurant worker, a teacher, or any job that you do, all those are spiritual jobs.
不管你是个工程师，或者是个商人，或者是个教师，不管你现在做什么，其实都是上帝给你一个角色。
Because God can use you in those jobs for His purposes.
因为上帝会用你在你的职场上来为他做见证。
In your jobs, you will be able to meet with daily and interact with people whom a pastor or missionary wouldn't necessarily have access to on a daily basis.
那在你工作的场合，在你所学习的地方，你都能够，你会接触到很多人，这些人是牧师跟宣教师所接触不到的。
God can use you to reach out to those people.
那神会用你来让他们来见到神。
And present the gospel message of salvation to them.
能够跟他们传讲神的福音。
So whatever role that God has called you and put you in, we should always have a personal devotion to Him, to grow more in love and respect for Him.
不管上帝呼召你做一位什么样的一个角色，那么我们都要在神面前来，在他跟神建立好的关系。
Only then can sacrificial service for God be worth it.
只有那样，只有我们有对神有爱、有敬仰的话，我们才会愿意去做出这些牺牲。
God, the one whom we love and respect, is worth serving.
上帝是值得我们所爱、所敬仰的。
Let's see what else in this passage that would teach us about why sacrificial service is worth it.
我们再接着看一下以下的经文，看到为什么牺牲性的侍奉是值得的。
Let us read from the last part of verse 25.
我们看25节后面一半段。
To make the word of God fully known, the mystery hidden for ages and generations, but now revealed to his saints. To them, God chose to make known how great among the Gentiles are the riches of the glory of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory.
要把神的道理传得全备，这道理就是历世历代所隐藏的奥秘，但如今向他的圣徒显明了。神愿意叫他们知道这奥秘在外邦人中有何等丰盛的荣耀，就是基督在你们心里成了有荣耀的盼望。
The Apostle Paul tells the Colossians that the reason why he's willing to suffer and make sacrifices is because of one great purpose.
那么使徒保罗跟哥罗西教会所说的他愿意为神侍奉是因为有个因为有个目的。
And this purpose makes the service worth it.
那这个目的就让这个牺牲的侍奉值得。
See, Paul refers to a certain mystery.
这一讲谈到了这个一个隐藏的奥秘。
This mystery refers to a truth that was once hidden, but now it is revealed by God.
这个奥秘呢，以前是大家不知道，但现在已经显明了。
See, before the gospel message of God was only revealed to the Jews at that time.
要知道福音以前这个救恩这个信息之前只是让犹太人知道的。
But now it is revealed to all the Gentiles as well.
那现在外邦人实际上就所有其他人所有的人都知道了。
So basically, the gospel message of salvation is for everyone.
这个救恩的道理是让是给每个人的。
First Timothy chapter 2 verses 3 and 4 says, "This is good, and it is pleasing in the sight of God our Savior, who desires all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth."
那么在提摩太前书第二章这么说到，这是好的，在我们神救主面前是可。
So God desires for all people to be saved.
神愿意万人得救。
See, the purpose that Paul is talking about is not just about presenting the gospel message to everyone.
我们想到这个保罗侍奉不只是让大家知道这些真道，不仅仅是停在这个地方。
Let's read verse 28.
我们可以看到28节。
Him we proclaim, warning everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom that we may present everyone mature in Christ.
我们传扬他是有诸般的智慧，劝诫个人，教导个人，要把个人在基督里完完全全地引到神面前。那实际上在原文他说是让所有人在基督里成熟，能够献给神。
So in addition for people to know the gospel,The ultimate goal is also for them to grow more mature in Christ.
所以首先是要知道这个正道，然后呢，在这个基础上再让大家在基督里来长大成人。
Because of this great purpose, the Apostle Paul is willing to suffer and serve sacrificially for God.
就是因为有这个目标，所以保罗愿意做牺牲性的去牺牲自己。
Why is sacrificial service worth the cost? Here's the second point. God entrusted us with the gospel worth making known.
那么为什么牺牲性的侍奉是值得的呢？这是强调第二点，因为神托付给我们的福音是值得去传开的。
There once was a man, and he was driving in a car with his wife.
那有就是一个丈夫开车带他的妻子。
The wife asked her husband if he wants to go eat ice cream at the parlor.
那么在开车的过程中呢，这个太太就问先生是不是可以买下冰淇淋。
Yeah, and you see, like, the husband answered very honestly.
那丈夫就随便就回答。
And he said that he was not in the mood for eating ice cream. He didn't want any right now.
他就说他现在不想吃冰淇淋。
A few minutes later, the wife starts crying.
然后过一会儿，这个太太就哭了。
And the husband asked her, what's wrong?
那这个现在就问为什么哭？
And as he said this, he then realized that when his wife was asking him whether he wanted to eat ice cream, she was basically asking if he wanted to spend time with her.
他其实讲的目的是他太太问话的意思说你可不可以跟我在一起多待一会儿。
So by saying no to ice cream, he was in a sense saying no to her.
所以这个太太所领受的就说你不愿意吃冰淇淋，就说你不愿意跟我在一起，所以她就哭了。
No, really, how come women just don't speak directly to their husbands about what they want?
好像女人就不愿意直接说一些跟先生说一些话。
So the husband said, fine, let's go get some ice cream right now.
那这个先生就说啊，那好，那我们现在就去冰淇淋吧。
The wife replied by saying, you forgot that today's our anniversary.
你忘了今天我们是结婚纪念日。
You see, if the husband didn't forget that it was the wife's, it was their anniversary, then, you know, initially he would have been more willing to, you know, to go spend time with her and have ice cream together.
那如果这位先生他知道今天是结婚周年的话，他会愿意去冰淇淋的。
See, when it comes to serving God, there's also something important that we should never forget.
所以，当我们侍奉神的时候，我们知道有些神给我们托付给我们的，我们是应该不会忘。
When we are not willing to serve sacrificially and suffer, we have lost sight of the mission we were sent on.And forgotten about what God has done in our lives.
我们不愿为神做牺牲，为神受苦，是因为我们已经忘记了我们被差的使命，还有神在我们生命中的作为。
So what can we do to help us not to forget?
那怎么样才能我们不忘记神所托付给我们的呢？
I guess first we need to remind ourselves about the great commission that Jesus had sent us on.
所以神给我们的大使命，我们是要记在心里的。
To go and make disciples of all nations and baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit and teaching them to be everything that He had taught us.
对，就是我们要去使忘了做我们的门徒，奉父子圣灵的名给他们施洗，仿耶稣给我们吩咐的，我们都教训他们遵守。
We can also remind ourselves about how great the power of the gospel is.
我们也看到这个福音是蛮有神的能力的。
Especially in how it can change and transform people's lives for the better.
我看到福音它会改变人。
Remind yourself about your own personal testimony.
我们可以想想神是如何改变我们自己的。
What did God do in your life and how did He change you after you have a relationship with Him?
当我们跟神成为神的儿女的时候，我们是如何改变的？
And I encourage all of you to share your testimonies with one another.
那我们经常也会互相做见证。
Let us remind one another this great purpose of serving.
让我们不忘记这个大使命。
To go and share the gospel with everyone, and not only that, but to help present them mature in Christ.
我们就去向我们所碰到的人来传讲神的福音，来见证神，并且我们也是让他们把他引到基督面前，能够成长。
Now, I believe this passage would teach us one more reason that would explain why is sacrificial service worth the cost.
那这段经文还提了另外一点，为什么牺牲性的侍奉是值得的？
This is the third point.
这是第三点。
God provides us with all we need to serve sacrificially.
就上帝供给我们一切所需的去做这个牺牲性的侍奉。
Let us read from verse 29.
我们看一下29节。
For this I toil, struggling with all his energy that he powerfully works within me.
我也为此劳苦，照着他在我里面运用的大能，尽心竭力。
You see, Paul served with the energy that is from God.
这谈到使徒保罗这么侍奉，因为是用神给他的大能。
He recognized that it is not by his own strength that he's serving.
他知道这不是靠他自己的能力。
It was God who worked in him and worked through him.
是神在用他，而且是神的大能在他心里来运行。
So in a sense, God should get all the credit and the work as a result of our service.
所以这个荣耀都归给神，这不是我们自己的。
So this is what I mean by God provides us with everything we need to serve.
神实际上是给我们一切所需的去侍奉他。
And right now, I would like to propose a theory.
那现在我想，给大家来说这么一个观点。
That sacrificial service is worth the cost because it does not cost us anything.
牺牲性的侍奉是值得的，因为他们不花费我们什么。
Now, what do we mean by that? What do you mean it doesn't cost anything?
那为什么这么说呢？为什么说不花我们什么呢？
Doesn't service usually cost us time, energy, and money?
这不是要花我们的时间吗？要花我们的能力吗？花我们的精力吗？
Let's say that you had a friend and he gave you $100.
这先生有个人给你100块钱。
And then you decide, no, I'm going to use the $100 to buy this friend a gift.
然后呢，你就想着用这100块钱给这个朋友买一个礼物。
And you gave the gift to him.
那你把这个礼物就给你这个朋友。
Now ask yourself this question. Did the gift cost you anything?
你就想想这个礼物花了你什么钱吗
？Yes, you spent the $100.
对，我花了100块钱。
But that $100 wasn't even yours to begin with.
但想想这个100块钱本来就不是你的。
So that's why the gift didn't cost you anything.
所以这为什么说我们侍奉神，其实就说这个礼物其实上是不花你什么钱的。
Likewise, God is the one who gave us our time, money, and energy.
那神是供应我们时间，供应我们精力，供应我们金钱。
He even gave us our life.
他给我们生命，他给我们生活。
When we use all of these resources to serve God sacrificially, then it doesn't cost us anything because all those things didn't even belong to us in the first place. God gave them to us.
当我们将这些东西献上的时候呢，实际上并不是牺牲我们什么东西，因为这本来就是神所赐给我们的。
And I hope that this gives us a different perspective on things.
所以我们可以让，我就想让大家从另外一个角度来看这个这牺牲性的侍奉。
Sacrificial service is worth the cost because it does not cost us anything.
牺牲性的侍奉是值得的，因为这不花费我们什么。
Let's talk about some application right now.
我们谈谈这如何应用在我们身上呢？
What are some of the reasons or excuses that we make for not being willing to serve sacrificially?
我们不愿做牺牲去侍奉神，是为什么呢？
A lot of times we just say, I don't have time. I'm too busy with my schoolwork, with my family, with my job.
我们常常最常听的原因就是因为我太忙了，我学习很紧很忙。或者是我工作很忙，或者是我家里很忙。
We may say church is too far away. It's too far away to drive, especially not only on weekends but maybe weekdays as well.
那或者是说教会太远了，不只是周末的，其实周日可能更有原因，因为教会太远了。
When preparing for mission trips, we may think that, oh, that trip is too dangerous. Well, what if we get sick? Or what if we get hurt when we're on this trip? And the trip costs too much money, too. Another excuse we may have is about language barriers. We may think, oh, my English isn't good enough to be able to serve in the English ministry or work with youth.
就比如说，或者我的英文不好，所以我就英文有关系的事情我就不参加了。
And on the other hand, you may also say, oh, my Chinese isn't good enough to be able to serve in Chinese ministry.
或者说，就是因为我的中文不太好，所以我不愿在中文来侍奉。
We may just say, someone else would just do it, not me. Or if I was going to serve, I would rather serve in the way that I want to. You see, when we realize that all of our time, money, and energy, and even our whole life is actually given to us by God, then we can be more willing to serve Him sacrificially. Those resources had originally belonged to God. And now, today, if you are already serving sacrificially in this church, I want to thank you for your faithfulness. But this may be the application for you. We should not think that we had did this particular service on our own or with our own strength. Remember to give God the credit. Because God is the one who had worked in you and through you. Now let us review the three things that we learned from this passage today. We are asking this question of why is sacrificial service worth the cost? And we saw three reasons. First, number one, God, the one whom we love and respect, is worth serving. So basically, because of the one who called us, because he is worth serving, that's what makes the service worth it. Number two, God entrusted us with the gospel worth making known. The goal, the purpose of our service alone is good enough. And finally, number three, God provides us with all we need to serve sacrificially.
现在来回顾就我们刚谈到这三点，就是第一点，为什么牺牲牺牲侍奉是值得呢？第一点就是说，因为我们所爱、所敬仰的神是值得侍奉的。这谈到就是因为神是我们所侍奉的对象是配得我们侍奉的。第二点就是我们刚才分享的谈到，就是说神托付我们的福音是值得我们去传开的，就是这个侍奉的这个目标，就是神的福音，这是值得我们去传开的。第三点，我们提到神供应我们一切所需的。
I'd like to close with this quote from a pastor named Jack Hiles. He said, God's people cannot be shamed into serving God. They need to be challenged. See, I'm not here today to make you feel shameful into serving God. Rather, I'm here to challenge you to put your trust and faith in God. Today, we talked about why sacrificial service is worth the cost. We can put our faith in God and trust that He has the perfect role for us based on our abilities. We can have faith in God that He will use us in our service to reach out to people and to present the gospel to them. We can have faith that God will provide you with the strength, with the energy, time, money, resources, anything to be able to help you to serve Him. You see, God can do all these things for us. So as a result, we can take that step of faith to serve Him sacrificially. Maybe today you're here at church for the first time and you may not be a Christian. I think there's an application for you here too.
我想对你们，我想跟大，跟你们所说的。
I would encourage you to think, if there are Christians in the church and all around the world who are really willing to serve sacrificially for God and give up a lot of their time, energy, money, and resources, then there must be something about God that makes him worthy for us to believe in him.
如果你看到你所接触的一些基督徒，他们愿意去做出这些牺牲，你会想到这个神他是一位如何的神，他必定是因为他们一定会有什么原因让他们去做这些牺牲的。
May we all put our full trust and faith in God as we serve sacrificially for Him.
愿我们大家都把我们的信心放在神的身上。
Let us pray.
我们一起祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父，
we know that we are weak without you.
我们知道我们都很软弱，没有你。
We know that we have our own types of thinking.
我们知道我们每个人都有各自不同的想法。
In ways that don't line up with yours.
都有这个想法想，就用我们的想法能够跟你的想法来合拍。
I pray that what we learned from your word today would take root in our hearts.
愿你的话语能够活在我们的心中。
Help us to examine ourselves to try to understand what are the reasons why we aren't so willing to serve sacrificially.
就是让我们去想想我们为什么不愿意为你去做牺牲。
Thank you for teaching us that we can be able to put our faith in you.
让我们想到我们在你里面我们是可以成为完全。
Knowing that you provide for us everything that we need.
我们知道，让我们满有信心知道你会供应我们所一切所需的。
Knowing that you alone, that the person of you, is even worthy to serve.
让我们知道你是值得我们去侍奉的。
And how there is a great mission for us to proclaim the gospel for all people.
让我们看到有这么一个目标，有这么一个大使命，让我们，这是你所托付给我们的使命。
All these things require for us to serve you sacrificially.
这些都是要求我们去做的牺牲。
Father, at this time, I'd like to ask us for forgiveness if we have sinned against you.
我是愿求主让我们能够来到你面前寻求你的赦免。
Help us turn back to you if we feel we have been away from you for some time.
愿赦免我们远离你。
Help us not to always be thinking about our own needs and our own desires.
让我们眼目不只是在我们自己身上，只是想到我们自己的需要。
For Lord, you alone are worthy of all things.
因为你配得我们的侍奉，配得我们的敬拜。
You created each and every one of us to love and serve you and worship you.
你创造我们每一个人，让我们能够去敬拜你，去侍奉你。
And we can have faith in you in that.
我们感谢主。
We lift up all these things in Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Amen.